blame Mom for trying to educate this household. Gosh.
Well, apparently, people think that I have way too many books. People think that I prefer buying books over actually reading them, whatever that means. So today, I'll be proving my haters wrong, and I'll be donating some of my books to my local thrift shop. And you think, yes, how generous of you, Zane. You are a good human being. Well, yes, I am a good human being. But I'm doing this because my thrift store will give me a 20% discount if you donate anything to them. And that way, I'll be able to buy other books that I will actually be reading and filling my house with more books. So suck it, haters. I'll always buy books. And buying books is a superior hobby than to actually reading them. So I'll be showing you the books that I'm unhauling them and why I'm unhauling these specific books. But be warned though, this is not an advertisement to get rid of your books. I am not an advocate of that. I support keeping your books, even if you don't read them. Rather, a way for me to show you how to get rid of some of your old books, the books that you already shown off to people, and replace them with new books that you can flex on your friends with. Let's get to it. So the first book that I'll be getting rid of today is Cinder. I know that I'll be getting a lot of hate for this, but hear me out. I honestly tried to read this book. I got through 200 pages, but I just could not get myself into it. And it just doesn't seem worthy to me to just like keep it. And it's not like any special copy. So I'll just be getting rid of it and hopefully some teenager picks it up. I don't know. Secondly, I have Miss Purgeon's Home for Peculiar Kids. I know that it's a good series, but I honestly have so many other books to read that it's not gonna find its place on my TPR soon. This book is actually stolen. Well, not actually stolen, but I got it from my high school library. They have a stand where it says free to take home books. And I didn't know if that was actually free. So when I went to get it, I kind of looked like I was stealing it. I took it, I read it for a minute in the library, then I just put it in my backpack real quick and then went away. And I still to this day don't know if it's free or not, but hey, I'll be putting it back into the world. So technically I'm not stealing, I'm just giving back, which actually I think that makes me Robin Hood now. Then we have Truth Be Told. It's a murder mystery. Honestly, I'm not that interested in it. I bought it from Dollar Tree, and the only reason I bought it for is because Jesse Pinkman from Breaking Bad has a show and he's starring in it.
This is my own private domicile and I will not be harassed, bitch!
So if it wasn't for Pinkman, I wouldn't have bought it, but now I'm just not that interested in the story and it seems like a waste of space to just have this here. I'm sorry, Jesse Pinkman and Kathleen Barber, the author, but hey, at least I'm putting this book back out, you know? Maybe somebody who's actually interested in reading it will pick it up. And here we have the Primer of Ecological Restoration. This is a book from one of my classes, and not only I'll be getting rid of this book, but I will be actively destroying it. Because this is a reminder every day, especially in the summer, that I am an active college student. And I do not like to be reminded of that. I would rather forget it until that financial aid check hits back. Then we have The Time Machine by H.G. Wells. I honestly bought this book because I really want to read it and I'm interested in H.G. Wells' books, but I did not realize that this illustrated edition was actually like a children abridged book. So I tried reading it and it just seems like not an actual adult book. And if you see this, you'll know what I mean. So yeah, maybe some kid will pick it up. Hopefully a parent buy that for their kids. But yeah, I'm not trying to read an adult abridged version. Then we have Cat and Mouse by James Patterson. I'll be getting rid of this book out of the pure hatred that I have for everything that James Patterson stands for in literature. And I hope that nobody actually picks this book up, because the less that James Patterson books are read, the better our society gets. I could make a whole episode about my disdain for James Patterson, but for today, I'll just be getting rid of his book.
I
ladies and gentlemen, someone to go out and go donate these books. We have them all right here. And you might think that I'll be taking either the GT Mustang or the regular Mustang behind me. But nay, everything that I need is all here in the Zanemobile. Let's rock and roll. So if there's anything that you should learn from today's video, is that you never have too many books. Don't let the doubters hate on you and stopping you from accumulating all those beautiful covers. So buy more books, make everyone around you more mad, because guess what? It's your money. And there is no better way to spend it. So I hope you enjoyed this video, and if you did, press like and subscribe, and if you do, I might bless you with more amazing content like this. See y'all around.